Hi friends, this is Dr. Krupa Savada and our today's topic of discussion is iodine poisoning, which is very important topic and it is organic irritants and it comes under the category of non-metallic poisons. If you are new to this channel, consider subscribing and sharing, and if you want more video links, you can visit the description box. So let us check out introduction first. Iodine is an essential micronutrient. It is vital for the production of iodine-containing thyroid hormones. So as it is an essential micronutrient, even government has taken an initiative to add this iodine into ordinary salt, right? And the deficiency of iodine has been recognized. Cases of iodine poisoning are rare. The poisoning from iodine is rare. Features. So it is bluish black, soft and scaly crystals with metallic luster. So the color is bluish black, soft and scaly crystals, right? It has an unpleasant taste and it gives off violet colored vapor. This is very important. The color of vapor is violet with an iodine like odor, which can be also said a characteristic odor, right? Let us see uses of iodine. It is antiseptic. It used in antiseptic preparation such as Lugol's iodine or tincture of iodine. So it is used in antiseptic preparation as well as therapeutic purpose, like RAI, that is radioactive iodine treatment, is used in the treatment of goiter. Even this particular radioactive iodine treatment can also be used in hyperthyroidism or in thyroid cancer. Mechanism of action. It is a protoplasmic poison that fixes protein and causes necrosis. So as it is protoplasmic poison, it causes necrosis, destroys the cell. Locally, a strong iodine solution may cause an intense irritation. If iodine is strong solution, then it creates intense irritation. If we see systemic toxicity is due to combination of free iodine with serum bicarbonate, causing metabolic acidosis, right? So serum bicarbonate plus combination of free iodine causing metabolic acidosis. It is also associated with hyperchloremia, hypernatremia, hyperosmolarity and renal failure. Okay. Iodine vapors are irritants to the respiratory passage. As we have seen previously that these vapors are violet in color, they are irritants to the respiratory passages. The fatal dose of iodine is 2 to 4 gram of iodine and the tincture 30 to 60 ml and the fatal period is 24 hours. Now let us check out clinical features which are very important. Iodine may cause acute or chronic poisoning. So let us see some of the clinical features of acute poisoning. The first one is inhalation. Vapor of iodine cause irritation of the respiratory tract. Rhinorrhea means watery discharge from nose and produce cough, pulmonary edema and glottic edema. Right? So edema in glottis, pulmonary edema, cough, rhinorrhea and irritation to the respiratory tract. Local, the application may cause irritation, inflammation, necrosis and resulting in yellowish brown skin staining, right? So this is very important. The skin staining will be yellowish brown. There will be irritation, inflammation and necrosis, right? Ingestion. When ingested, iodine acts as corrosive, right? When it is taken internally, it acts as a corrosive, causing pain that extend from the mouth to the abdomen, increased salivation, a metallic taste, vomiting and diarrhea. So GI symptoms you will get, like in excessive salivation or increased salivation, metallic taste, vomiting and diarrhea. The vomitus may be dark brown or blue in color with an iodine odor. So there will be a characteristic odor of vomitus with dark brown or blue color. Iodine may cause nephritis, renal failure with suppressed urine or scanty urine. So urine will be suppressed or scanty and it causes nephritis and renal failure, right? Urine is red brown in color and contains albumin. Okay, so the color of urine is red brown. Iodine induced acute salidinitis, right, that is called as iodide mumps, consisting of diffuse submandibular and parotid gland enlargement. So here we have seen, we have put one picture that shows iodide mumps, right, which is also called as salidinitis, right, and it has been identified as a complication associated with use of iodide in contrast radiography, right? So certain times in contrast radiography iodine is used. Okay, so it is a complication of it. Chronic poisoning, which is also called as iodism, it causes metallic taste, anorexia, insomnia, lymphadenopathy and emaciation. So it causes all these things like anorexia, insomnia, there will not be a sleep or lack of sleep, lymphadenopathy and emaciation, right? Parotid swelling, which is seen in this first picture. Stomatitis, here we have shown the stomatitis in another picture. Conjunctivitis means inflammation of conjunctiva. Then rhinorrhea, watery discharge from nose, and skin manifestation in the form of erythema, urticaria and acne, together referred as ioderma, right? So there will be skin manifestation. Let us check out management. Management for acute poisoning. So decontamination is very, very, very important to remove iodine from the body. Okay. Skin exposure, wash with copious water or 20% alcohol. Eye exposure, irrigation of eye with running water, means with copious or enough water, right? GIT, gastric lavage can be attempted if no esophageal injury is presented or suspected. So even we can give gastric lavage, but this is to evaluate that there is no esophageal injury, right? Sodium bicarbonate for metabolic acidosis, hemodialysis followed by continuous venous hemodiafiltration. So this is very important. Certain times it is important to do hemodialysis, but कभी कभी पेशेंट जो है वो हीमोडायलिसिस जो है वो जो नहीं कर सकता, मीन्स इट विल बी डिफिकल्ट फॉर अ पेशेंट. तो अगर वो हीमोडायलिसिस अगर सहन नहीं कर सकता है, राइट, देन कंटिन्यूअस विनोवीनस हीमो डायफिल्ट्रेशन कैन बी डन, राइट, एंड सपोर्टिव मेजर्स. क्रॉनिक पॉइजनिंग, स्टॉप आयोडीन इंटेक एंड इंक्रीज इंटेक ऑफ सोडियम क्लोराइड. वाई? बिकॉज sodium chloride will compete with iodide at the level of renal tubules and thus promote the excretion of iodides, right? So to take sodium chloride is very important and stop iodine intake. Autopsy findings, clothes will have yellow stains, right? The stains of iodine. The skin, lips, angle of mouth and mucosa will be stained yellowish brown. Gastric mucosa may be yellowish brown in color. However, it may be blue if starch is present in the stomach or starch solution is used to treat the patient. If starch is present, then the color will change as a blue, right? Iodine-like odor, characteristic odor you will get, and congestion of organs. Medico-legal importance. As we have seen previously, iodine poisoning is rare. Accidental poisoning may occur due to therapeutic exposure, right? Certain times due to therapeutic exposure, accidental poisoning may occur, and iodinated radiographic contrast media or agents are known to produce anaphylactic reactions. So certain times there will be anaphylactic reaction also. Production of anaphylactic reaction is done by usage of iodinated radiologic contrast media. Thank you for watching this video. You can subscribe this channel, click bell icon and share this video amongst your friends. Thank you.